Today we're going to go around the world in 10 hot sauces. Or are we? Got a gift for the holidays, and I have to say in advance that our review today does not in any way reflect our feelings or thoughts about the person that gave us this gift. Ain't that right, Stink Pot? Now, why your aunt and I call each other Stink Pot? Actually, she calls me Stink Pot, so yeah, term of endearment for my sister, but. She gave us this box set from World Market, and what it is, is a box set of 10 hot sauces from around the world. So it looked like a really cool gift, but then I started looking at it, and we're going to review all the sauces today, but I started glancing at it, and the more I looked, it turns out they're not sauces from around the world. They're actually sauces that are all made in the USA, inspired by global sauces. So that was one thing that I noticed that was kind of bizarre. The other thing was, it's got it down here where it's marked no heat, to mild, to hot, to very hot. But the funny thing is, the no heat ones are 0 to 500 Scoville units, but the very hot ones are only 3,000 to 5,000 Scoville units. So if you give us some context on that.
Well, the very hot stuff is only the level of Tabasco, so that means not that hot.
And not even as hot as a higher end jalapeno, right?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, and habaneros are 100,000 Scoville up to 350,000 Scoville. So the range, especially for chili heads like us, it is very, very, very limited. These are all going to be pretty mild. But we're going to give it the benefit of the doubt, and we're going to try them out one by one and see what we think of the World Market Global Hot Sauce Set. Okay, first in the hot sauce, the Global Hot Sauce box, is the Smoky Bourbon Pepper Hot Sauce, which, of course, is to be a tribute to Bourbon Street, and features aged red cayenne peppers. A little on the harsh side.
Kind of strong as you put it in your mouth, but then it's like
high in vinegar for sure.
Yeah, but then it's like really mild.
Yeah.
Like after that.
It has that Tabasco
sort of taste.
Harshness to it.
In fact, it tasted a little bit more harsh, didn't it, to you?
Yeah, even more harsh than Tabasco. Any smoky bourbon overtones?
Just tastes like any other hot sauce.
Yeah, it didn't taste any smoke. Just very heavy vinegar. So what'd you think of that one for flavor and heat?
Probably 6 or 7 for flavor, and for heat, probably a 3.
Yeah, it was very average for me. I'd give it probably 4 for flavor and a 3 for heat. All right, the next one is the Indian Tiger Blood Chipotle Pepper Hot Sauce. And that one features red chipotle peppers and garlic and onions, which is obviously a tribute to Indian sauces.
Good flavor.
You like that one?
Mm-hmm.
Trying to place the flavor.
Reminds me of Indian food, obviously.
Yeah, a little bit of that. Tiger blood. Very little heat again.
Yeah.
You agree?
Yeah. Surprisingly, that one had a bit more heat, the bourbon.
Another one that has strong vinegar overtones. Every single one of these sauces has quite a bit of vinegar in them. What do you give overall for flavor then?
Probably 7.
Okay, heat?
Heat, probably give it a 2 or 1. Maybe 2, yeah, 2.
Yeah, it was another average one for me. I probably 4 again for flavor. And yeah, 3 for heat. The third sauce is it's not flamenco, it's the flamenco jalapeno pepper sauce, hot sauce. Featuring jalapeno peppers and similar vinegar. Get a good spoon of that.
Different taste.
Similar to the Tabasco jalapeno?
Yeah.
Very thin sauces. Yeah, generally a thinner sauce. You know, Nick tends to like a little bit thinner sauce. I like a little bit thicker sauce. You just don't want sauce that's super thin. These taste like quite thin. What are your feelings on that one for flavor and heat?
Heat, I'd probably give it a... Or no, not 4. Probably 3 again. For flavor, I give it a 7. Wait, 6. Yeah, 6.
Okay. I'm not a real fan of this one either. running theme here, right? Probably give it a 4 again. And yeah, 2 for heat. Now on to the Hawaiian lava flow. This one actually has aged red habanero peppers and a vegetable blend of onions and carrots. Though this is still on their version of the milder sauces, so even though there's habaneros in it, it can't have much for habaneros, because habaneros are extremely hot. It's got a little slightly orange.
For the habanero pepper itself, it's extremely hot. Usually in sauce, they dilute it a little bit.
All right, let's try it.
Definitely has habanero taste, but not habanero heat.
It's got the hint of habanero. You can pick up on that. I can also pick up on the carrots. It's got an orange hue to it. Another harsh with the vinegar.
Yeah.
You fan of that one, the Hawaiian lava flow?
For flavor, probably give it a 5. Heat, probably a 3 again for heat.
Yeah,
or maybe even a 3 or 4, I should say.
That one might inch up to a 5 for me for flavor, because I like habanero. It's a tiny bit better than the first couple of them. Heat, again, maybe 2 or 3. All right, the fifth sauce, smoking Jamaican jerk hot sauce. Interesting thing, though, about this sauce, it's almost exactly the same ingredients as the Hawaiian lava flow. Also has aged red habaneros and a vegetable blend. I don't know if they had like a generic vegetable blend that they put in all these. Another interesting, you can tell what sauces, if they cut corners or not. Like on the last one in the title, there was mango listed, but there's no actual mango in the sauce. So all right, so let's give this one a try, the Smokin' Jamaican.
Pretty good flavor.
Yeah, that one's better. I like that. That one reminds me a little bit of Clamato. Did you ever have Clamato?
No, I never heard of it.
It's like a tomato juice and clam. Tomato and clam juice.
Sounds gross, but yeah. I'm guessing it's not.
It does sound gross, but I actually like it. I don't know. Thoughts, heat, flavor?
Heat probably give it a...
Anecdotes?
I'd probably give it a 2 for heat, 2 for heat. And for flavor, I'd probably give it a... maybe 7. In the 7 or 8 position.
Yeah, I'd give it a... I give it a 6 for flavor and a 2 for heat, yeah. Hey, just a quick note. The music that you heard at the beginning of this video and that you'll hear at the end of the video is from one of my all-time favorite bands. They're called The Rainmakers, and I've been in love with their music since 1986 when their debut album came out. And they were featured in Newsweek magazine as one of the most exciting new American bands. If you get into singer-songwriters like Bruce Springsteen or Bob Dylan or bands like Wilco, Jayhawks, you definitely want to check out The Rainmakers. Their music is fantastic. I'm friends with the lead singer and songwriter, Bob Walkenhorst, ever since that record came out. And if you check the description, down in the description, I will have a link to their website and online store. So we're honored to be able to use their music in our vids, and thanks a lot, Bob. The Australian sauce, my Outback is burning. and this one has Tabasco and habanero peppers. Again, very similar ingredients. We're gonna do a second part to this video, and in that, we're going to research and find 10 global hot sauces from the same countries that they had, you know, put in here, that would be much better replacements for just making generic sauce from the U.S. All right, the Australian tribute one.
Ooh. Yeah.
That's very harsh.
Really?
You didn't think so? Ooh, it was like a vinegar bomb.
I thought the bourbon one was twice as harsh.
Really? Okay.
I mean, it was harsh, but definitely not as harsh as you probably thought it was.
Nah, that's one of the worst flavors I've tried.
For flavor for that one, I'd probably give a flavor for 6. For heat, probably a 3.
A 6. I give this one a 2 for flavor.
Really?
Heat, yeah. It tastes like it's 80% vinegar. Heat was a little bit hotter, but it's kind of like Tabasco is very low on the Scoville scale, but seems a lot hotter than it is because the vinegar makes it a little bit more harsh.
Yeah, Sean's changed the Scoville scale because of how much vinegar they put in.
Yeah, yeah. So I give a 3 to this one for heat. The 7th one, the Mexican style hot sauce with cayenne peppers again. Let's give this one a spin.
Good flavor.
Yeah, much better than the Australian one.
A bit hotter. That's not from, well, it could be just, you know, the stuff going down in my throat a little bit. So, for heat, I'd probably give it a 4 for heat.
Okay.
For flavor, I'd probably give it a, 7, yeah.
Little hints of Cholula to that one, you think?
Maybe.
Okay, a little bit. Not nearly as good as Cholula, though, right?
No, definitely not. I rate Cholula, actually, Cholula is actually one of my favorite. I probably rate Cholula like 10 out of 10 for flavor.
Okay, Cholula is one of our all-time favorite. For mainstream sauces, it's definitely one of the best. Yeah, this one, I know, 5 flavor, 3 for heat. On to the Rio de Janeiro sauce. This is the habanero pepper sauce, tribute to Brazil sauce. Strangely, almost identical ingredients again, aged red habaneros, vegetable blend, that generic vegetable blend again. Yeah, I tell you, with this whole set, this is a phenomenal idea for a gift. I'm really surprised. I mean, world market isn't supposed to be exotic, imported goods and interesting stuff. This is just, it's really surprising, because you could have had 10 mind-blowing sauces, and it couldn't have been that expensive to do that. And with a very wide range of flavors, and instead, it's just, it's almost like 10 sauces on repeat. Like, they made them all out, they probably made them all out of the same factory. All right, let's try this one. Oh, again, vinegar. Holy vinegar.
Really? That's like one of the...
You must love the vinegar. Well, they're calling you vinegar boy.
But I reacted a lot to the bourbon one, so obviously I don't like it that much. Really? Like, that one wasn't that bad.
This one's light years away from a really good habanero sauce. Like, the one that Southwest Specialty makes, it's called Pure Habanero, made from Red Savina habaneros. That is, you know, that is profound with its wonderful habanero taste. This, yeah. But what do you think? Flavor?
Flavor, probably give it a... 7 again. I'm giving a lot of these 7s for some reason.
Oh, you're so off base.
What? It's my opinion.
I know.
Anyway,
I know.
7 for flavor.
And you know what they say about opinions. Just kidding. Oh.
Let me give the heat. So yeah, 7 for flavor, 3 for heat, I'm saying.
All right. Yeah, 3 for flavor and 3 for heat. To the African sauce, the Kenyan Fire Tusk pepper sauce with Tabasco peppers. And a mix of aged red habanero and Tabasco peppers. And same thing. Does not have the generic vegetable blend, though.
A bit more vinegar in that one.
We must be picking up a different vinegar. That one seemed like less vinegar to me.
Really? That one seemed like more vinegar to me.
I think it's like the great vinegar debate. It's not the world hot sauce. It's the great vinegar.
It seems like when I pick up more vinegar, you pick up less vinegar. When you pick up more vinegar, I pick up less vinegar.
Would you rebuy any of these sauces as a standalone?
Sure, why not?
You would? Okay.
Yeah, only the really good ones from here.
But none of these are. I mean, would you say? I mean, I don't think that any of these compare to like even like your typical Tabasco, Cholula.
No, Prince Tabasco is still way better than all these.
Yeah, I mean, if you're gonna have an exotic hot sauce box from around the world, you should at least, right, aspire to be at least comparable or better than the grocery store mainstream stuff, I would think. To the final vinegar insult, the Death Valley Scorch and Pepper Hot Sauce, tribute to California and the USA. Again, aged red habaneros and the generic vegetable blend. Let's give it a spin.
It's like, just make the same sauce already. Jeez, it's like, it's not even worth making different sauces. Plus, they all taste the same.
Yeah, they really do all taste the same.
These are like so generic. It's like, just make regular sauces.
But I don't know, I call into question your 7s that you gave, and I'm just kidding.
Well, because... To me, 7 is pretty bad.
I think the one reviewer is suspect here.
In my world, 7 is actually pretty bad.
I think you work for World Market. 7's pretty bad. Yeah, in your world, you're delusional. All right.
Let's just say 7's decent.
Let's just say...
These sauces are decent, so 7's decent.
Let's say the one reviewer is a little off. All right, final one, Death Valley. Into Death Valley, my friend.
Not much vinegar in that one.
Not as much, yeah. Not as much vinegar.
Finally, we agree with each other.
Flavor's decent. Flavor's the only variation on all of these, besides the jalapeno one, had a little bit, you know, leaned a little bit towards Tabasco jalapeno. The rest of them could all be the same, exactly the same, right?
Yeah, that one I'd probably give a 5 for flavor and probably a 2 for heat.
Yeah, a little bit better than some of the other ones. I give it 5 for flavor and 3 for heat. And that was supposed to be the hottest one. So the hottest one falls underneath what a normal jalapeno would be. So, all right. So that was the World Market Global Hot Sauce Gift Box Set. Coming up in a future video in a few weeks or so, maybe in a month, we'll be doing part two of this. Yeah. And in the meantime, we're going to find 10 sauces that will blow these 10 sauces away.
I give
and
this,
do up a global hot sauce box the right way.
I give this company a thumbs down. No, I'm just kidding. I'd say I give it a decent thumb.
A decent thumb?
Like this.
Almost the thumbs up.
Where it's like a decent, and then kind of leaning down a little bit, like this.
So it was a nice gift. Thank you.
Stink pot.
Thank you, stink pot. And we give it a sideways thumbs up. Maybe it does reflect our feelings. No.
Yeah, sideways.
Thanks for all the support. We love you. Thanks for watching, and see you guys
later!